But what I called the message is passing timeless truth into turbulent times. And it's been turbulent times for the last 2.5 years for sure with COVID and all the different reactions and elections and all the things that have really seemed to have polarized our culture. And it's similar to when a storm blows through, only the things that are rooted and grounded make it through the storm. If it's trees and there's loose branches, the loose branches get broken off. And Jesus said, if you abide in me, I'm the vine. If you abide in the vine, then you get the fruit. So when things get rough around us, we stand on our firm foundation. My house is built on the rock, not on the sinking sand of this culture, right? And it's not always easy to think of that. That's one of the ways that we all could help each other so much is that we talk to each other about our lives and how God has used us and the testimonies that we have. I said it earlier while I was singing that song about Egypt and being bred out of Egypt. I was missing some of the words because I had such a clear picture of what he was delivering me out of. And I just got so grateful in that moment, and it kind of just catches your breath away that he would take such a mess and turn it around, and whatever he would choose to use, I shouldn't even be alive. So any good that comes from my life is a blessing. But the more the better, amen? The more that we could be used as weapons in the hand of the Lord to destroy the works of the devil, the more God is pleased with our lives, right? The Son of Man was manifest that he might destroy the works of the enemy. So what's the challenge here? The older man is in the front, and then time is going away from the older man, and you would think it's 3 generations here. That's how I interpreted it. And the gap between the man with the beard and the boy at the back gets bigger with every passing generation. And I'm going to touch on that today because I think that we all need to try to make a decision in our heart to be intentional about reaching out to younger people. Okay? We don't always think that they want to hear what we have to say, and they might not want to hear what we have to say. But what about you wanting to hear what they say? Thank you, Nate. He's like my foot pedal there. Special effects. And I'm going to talk about that, so I don't want to jump it. But my text verse is right there in Matthew 7:14. It's the end of the Sermon on the Mount. And Jesus said, wide, I'll just read it, right? Enter by the narrow gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leads to destruction. And there are many who go by that road of destruction. But narrow is the gate, and difficult the way which leads to life, and there are few who find it. Now, that's a little sobering, isn't it? We want to be the few that find it every day, right? When he said, lead us not into temptation, he wasn't saying that God was purposely leading us into temptation. He was saying, no, make us aware of where this wide road could lead me to destruction and keep me focused on your compass so that I can hit that narrow road in every situation, in every conversation that I have, in every interaction that I have. I pull in to get gas. It's not the gas attendant's fault that it's expensive, okay? Don't blame him. If your hamburger comes out cold, don't blame the waitress, all right? They're short-handed. They're having a hard time right now in the restaurants, right? Like, you could be in church for 2 hours and then go out to lunch with people and they get rude with the people who work there. Like, what happened to those 2 hours of worshiping? So all these things is still a narrow road. And, you know, how many times have you been with people in a restaurant and they give a prophetic word to the waitress? Or to the waiter, or to the guy who's bringing stuff to the table. They're not used to people treating them kindly, at least not always. Our son said, 80% of the people are really nice, but the other 20% are psychos. So all I'm saying is, don't think it's just for the big stuff, because everything to God is big, and all relationships are really big to him, okay? So that's how I'm applying this today. And you know, maybe a subtitle would be Timeless Truth for Turbulent Times. Okay, we're in turbulent times. You have to believe that when Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life, that is rock solid. That's never going to change. That is true. As much as people want to hammer that message and try to knock it down, they can't because it's true. We build our lives on that rock. And then you could pick hundreds of verses like this. I just gave you a few that relate to salvation. and because that's never going to change. After we're gone, people are still going to need to get saved and filled with the Holy Spirit. All have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Does anybody here disagree with that? We recognize as Christians that all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God, and we can't save ourselves. But there's good news. Acts 2:21, whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. That's true. You don't have to hand in your resume and wait for their people to call your people. Call on the name of the Lord. He will save you. The thief on the cross. Remember me. That's all he said. Lord, remember me, Lord. Never went to church. Never got baptized. Never read a Bible. Who knows? Maybe he did. I don't know. But he sure wasn't in a good situation. And he was like one of those lobsters when you go to the supermarket and they're in that fish tank. It's like, things ain't looking good for us, bro. I don't know if we're getting back to the ocean. When you get nailed to that cross, man, there's not a lot of options. So this guy was calling out, and just even at the last second, it's never too late. Don't wonder if your loved ones are in heaven or hell. You don't know if they cried out to the Lord before they passed. Selah. Acts 2:38, repent. And let every one of you be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the redemption of sins. You shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. That's a good promise. I don't know where I'd be without the gift of the Holy Spirit. I would probably be like Jack Frost, if you ever heard his testimony. And he used the word of God to beat people up, to constantly bring condemnation. It was never enough, because that was what he came out of until he got healed. And the letter without the Spirit kills people. But the Spirit without the law kills people too, right? They just float off into outer space. So we need the grounding in the Word. The Lord is seeking those who will worship Him in spirit and in truth. But what a great promise. If I repent and get baptized and claim Jesus as my Lord and Savior, He fills me with His Spirit. That's really good news. All of you that said this have His Spirit in you. I believe personally we don't fully yield to the Spirit in us in every dimension of our lives, and that's another thing we can work on a regular basis. Where am I not yielded to you? Where am I allowing my opinions to override the truth of the Word of God? Because you remember I taught a message that said all truth is inconvenient to somebody. I thought I could go 80 miles an hour on the parkway. Oops. Inconvenient. Points on my license. I thought I could talk to somebody on my phone while I was driving my car. No judgment zone. If you get the ticket, it's expensive. I'll leave it at that. Malachi 4 said in verses 5 and 6, the last verses of the Old Testament, behold, I will send you Elijah the prophet before the great and awesome day of the Lord. He will what? Say it with me. Turn the hearts of to the children. I think the order there really matters, and it's not just fathers, it's parents, but it specifically says fathers, right? The thing that has to change, the reason I mentioned that each of us should be more intentional about talking to young people, not to lecture them, but to talk to them and get their feedback, the reason is they can teach you something, okay? They can teach you something. I grew up, my dad and I had a pretty good relationship, not phenomenal, but pretty good, all things considered. And I don't ever remember him telling me once that he learned anything from me. But I have learned so much from my two sons. It's been amazing. We feed off of each other, and they call me because they want my advice and not money. It's an awesome feeling. But it was because I had to open my heart to even think I could learn something from them. And maybe you don't suffer from that, but our culture does. And, you know, don't make blanket generalizations. Oh, Gen X, they're this, they're that. They're shiftless, they're distracted, they're lazy. Stop cursing our young people. No. What have you done to invest in them? How many do you know? How many conversations have you had? Not trying to put a guilt trip on anybody. It's just a revelation that he gave me that I want to share. Because we are holding timeless truth, because God is not in time, but we are in time. And that makes it difficult to keep translating it with fluency to the next generation. And they're not going to try to teach you their language. They're not going to try to get you to like their quote-unquote music. we became that older person that said, that's not music. Back in my day, that was really music. This has been going on forever. He'll turn the hearts of the fathers to the children, and then when that happens, the hearts of the children will open up to their fathers, and they'll be willing to hear from us. But they want us to start on equal footing, not the sage on the stage pointing down, and I know all the answers. And when I was your age, careful. It's like Charlie Brown, remember? Wah, 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 wah. They shut their ear off. Lest I come and strike the earth with a curse. I mean, this was written a long time ago. And God is saying, the older people, it's an obligation. It's not a suggestion. We have to try to pass these timeless truths down to them in a way that they can receive it. Not based on what we thought. And that's a challenge. It's really a challenge today.